Storm in me. let it be pleasing, Lord, to thee. And should I gain any praise, let it go to Calvary. With his blood he hath saved me.
Jesus Christ is King. today's the program Behind the Badge, which is an outreach ministry, the Canadian Fellowship of Christian Peace Officers. My name is Laverne Ellenberger. I'm the host of your program. And with us on the set, we have the Chief of Police from the Village of Sterling Police Department, Jack Foster. And we also have his lovely wife here, Ruth, with him today. Jack, we've been trying to get you here for a long time, so we want to say welcome today to the program. And you want to tell us a little bit about yourself, how you first got involved in police work, and how long? Yeah.
It was just all listening. But I was quite a bit later in life. But praise the Lord that he finally got through to me. I really do thank him for that. But I've been a born-again Christian, I guess, for about 10 or 11 years now, where I was truly born again. And it was the most wonderful experience of my life, because it changed my whole life. Everything in my life changed.
You really felt something different inside.
Oh,
I did.
You just
didn't say, well, I'm going to be different now, or I'm going to go to church,
no.
And we're going to do this and that.
No.
Something happened in here, eh?
I could hardly wait to get down to church for anything that was going on. I wanted to be involved in everything I could that had to do with the Lord Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And I suppose, like a lot of new Christians, you know, you're sort of walking 10 feet high,
yeah,
maybe even higher. And it's so exciting, and I was really, and I'm still excited, but I was very excited. I'm
yeah,
a very excitable type of person, and everything looked different, and I didn't have to have anybody say to me, now you're a Christian, you shouldn't do this, and you shouldn't do that. I always have the Holy Spirit, as I came
conviction
to know,
inside,
within
yeah,
me, saying to me, you know, you
yeah,
don't do things that way now. And I really wanted, I had the Lord on my mind all the time.
Mm-hmm.
He was just constantly on my mind. And I wanted so much to please him. And you don't stay like that, of course, every day being human. You
yeah,
know, our human nature comes into it some days. But one thing I'm very thankful for is that the Holy Spirit tells me.
That's
he
a good point
me,
that you brought out there, that some people think that because you become a Christian, now you've got to stop doing this and stop doing that and stop maybe running with the old crowd. But not a matter of stopping. It's a matter of the Holy Spirit speaking inside. And it's not your head. It's in here.
That's that, right.
That you just don't have the desire now to do those things.
Oh, no.
And God gives you a new desire, and that's what happened to both of you.
That's
there,
right. Just to please him and do things for him. I you know, anything that you go to do, you think, now would this be pleasing
yeah,
to the Lord? Is this what he would have me do?
Yeah.
And as I say, we do slip. I think everybody slips sometimes, but praise the Lord, he's always there to pick us up again.
Up, yeah.
And I'm just so thankful to him.
Well, we have our days. Physically, when we feel up and
that's
we feel
right,
down, and
mm-hmm,
can be the same way in our spiritual life.
That's
but
right,
we don't feel like getting up in the morning, but we get up anyway, and we have to mm-hmm, do the same in our spiritual life there.
That's right.
And as we eat and drink the spiritual food, we do grow stronger, and this is what has kept you through the years.
Oh, yes.
Jack, being a policeman and being a Christian, can you do these two jobs? Can you be a Christian and a policeman too?
Yes, you definitely can. I like to think that I'm a Christian first, a policeman second. But they can go hand in hand. Now, a lot of viewers wouldn't agree with that. They say, no, you can't.
Yeah.
You couldn't do your job effectively. I disagree. In fact, I like to think that I can do it more effectively. Because I think, you're a team then.
Yes.
Now, I was, what, about 2 years ago, dear, that I was attacked. I was attacked
mm-hmm,
by a young lad in a break-in,
mm-hmm,
and to keep it short, he went after me with a tire iron. He was trying to waste me,
uh-huh,
and after we scrambled around, I got the best of him, and talking to him later when things calmed down, I said, you know, you thought I was all alone there, didn't you? And he looked at me and he says, I think I know where you're coming from.
Mm-hmm.
I said, I wasn't alone. No matter where I go, the Lord's guiding me. And I was able to witness to him. And he made a commitment to the Lord.
He made a commitment.
He did.
Oh, yeah, it was wonderful.
And,
wasn't that something?
It was encouraging because even though he had tried to kill me, I found it within my heart to forgive him. Mm-hmm. Humanly speaking, I couldn't do that. But I was able to do that, and he asked me to forgive him as well. In that we have these opportunities right on the front line, and you might say in the trenches, like they said in the army.
You're right up where the
trouble is at the time. And a due word and due season often can be very effective. And I truly think that a man, when a policeman that's got that has the Lord on his side, has that extra measure.
Yeah.
I like to think more compassionate and overall more effective.
Yes.
More understanding. And maybe you can see things a little better too. I think it gives you that extra perception.
Perception, yes, to do the job and solve cases and so on.
You can see beyond. I think with his strength, you can see beyond the situation at hand right at the time.
And that's what a police officer has and an investigator has to be able to do. See the present and before and then beyond that there. Plus the fact, it must give you a good feeling though that when you go into a dangerous situation or when you're working at night and down back alleys and so on, to feel that you're just not walking out there alone and that you might get shot and this and that might happen to you. Like you said, you're not alone. And today, we hear more and more about police officers and jail guards and so on being killed all over the country, something we'd very seldom heard years ago. And yet, we don't have to worry about that when you're born again.
That's right. We know our destination.
Yes.
And the Bible says, we're appointed unto a man wants to die.
Yes.
And after that, the judgment. And that's been taken care of by Christ dying on the cross of Calvary for us. And that is comforting. I know it's comforting from my point of view because I know, particularly with my wife being a Christian, that I know the moment I strike out, and I often get called out in the wee hours in the morning, because
mm-hmm.
we're police in a small town,
mm-hmm.
and I'm a working police chief, and not too many of us around. But I get called out, and I know that my wife's praying for me every time I leave the house. And I have that inner strength when I leave. Now, you're not foolish about it. You don't go put yourself in a volatile situation or stand out in front of somebody that's you know, carrying a gun or something. But you certainly have that extra comfort to know that the Lord is with you. And he does. It's strange. I make a habit of committing myself to the Lord before I get to this, arriving in a situation. I simply say, usually I say, Lord, I don't know what I'm going into. And you don't, as a police officer.
That's right, yeah.
You have very sketchy information as to, it might be a domestic situation, it might be a gun involved, you may not know there's a gun involved even, but you're going into it, and you have to make split-second decisions, and I find if I just commit it to the Lord and say, Lord, I don't want getting in.
A lot of people think because we're in a smaller village, that nothing happens.
I know.
And we get that so often, but you know, things can happen anywhere because it only takes one person,
usually,
to cause somebody's life to disappear. And I just know that when he goes out, I never know what he's going to either. But God has really been good. He's been really good to both of us in so many ways, and I know that he's looked after him. And he's given me a peace after I pray that, you know, if I didn't have the Lord to turn to, I could very well be up all night worrying about him. But I can pray to God, and then I can go back to sleep and just give him the worry and commit it to him. Yeah, he's...
You and Jack sing together. And we're going to go away just for a few moments, and Jack and Ruth is going to bring us a song or or two, I'm not sure which, and then we'll be right back with you.
Rita Stethem. Also to sing for you this time are Jack and Ruth Foster from Stirling, Ontario.
I come to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ear. The Son of God discloses, and He walks with me, and He talks with me, and He tells me I am His own, and the joy we share as we tarry. None other has ever known. He speaks, and the sound of His voice is so sweet. The birds hush their singing, and the melody that He gave to me within my heart is ringing. And He walks with me, and He talks with me, and He tells me I am His own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known.
What have I ever done to deserve even one of the blessings I ever do that was worthy of You and the kindness You show?
Lord, help me, Jesus, I've wasted it, so help me, Jesus, I know what I am. Needed You, so help me, Jesus, my soul's in Your hands.
Show me, Lord, if You think there's a way I can try to repay all I've taken from You. Maybe, Lord, I can show someone else what I've been through myself on my way back to You.
Lord, help me, Jesus, I've wasted it, so help me, Jesus, I know what I am. And now needed You, so help me, Jesus, my soul's in Your hands. Jesus, my soul's in Your hands.
Now back again with us is Steve.
To be, it took him just a week to make the moon and the stars, the sun and the earth and Jupiter and Mars. How loving and patient he must be. He's still working on me.
There really ought to be a sign upon my heart. Don't judge me yet, I'm an unfinished part. But I'll be perfect according to his plan, fashioned by the master's loving hand. He's still working on me to make me what I ought to be. It took him just a week to make the moon and the stars, the sun and the earth and Jupiter and Mars. How loving and patient he must be. He's still working on me. The mirror of his word, reflections that I see, makes me wonder why he never gave up on me. But he loves me as I am and hears me when I pray. Remember, he's the potter, I'm the clay. He's still working on me to make me what I ought to be. It took him just a week to make the moon and the stars, the sun and the earth and Jupiter and Mars. How loving and patient he must be. He's still working on me. He's still working on me to make me what I ought to be. It took him just a week to make the moon and the stars, the sun and the earth and Jupiter and Mars. How loving and patient he must be. He's still working on me. He's still working on me. He's still working on me.
Are you tired of chasing pretty rainbows? day at a time, sweet Jesus. That's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. I'm only human, I'm just a man. Help me believe in what I can be and all that I am. Show me the stairway I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus. That's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Do you remember when you walked among men? Well, Jesus, you know, when you're looking below, it's worse now than then. Cheating and stealing, violence and crime. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus. That's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a there's not a king with more splendor than them. Consider the sparrows, they don't plant nor sow, but they're fed by the Master who watches them grow. We have a Father above, with eyes full of mercy, a heart full of love. He really cares when your head is bowed low. Consider the lilies, and then you will know. Friend of mine who hangs out the
full of mercy, a heart full of love. He really cares when your head is bowed low. Consider the lilies, and then you
second Tuesday in the month we meet.
Yes.
This next meeting is on February the 9th. It's a Tuesday night at Hastings Park Bible Chapel in Harder Drive in Belleville. And it's a potluck, 6:30. So if anybody, the policeman or a peace officer down that way, just feel free to come along, bring the family and a couple of dishes and join in the fellowship. We have a wonderful time.
Thank you. And yeah. Ruth, you were involved in this too, with Jack?
Yes. I think the other wives have pretty well, you know, mentioned about it, but it is something that we can go to too, and also the children, if you have small children. And like, this is pretty nice that we are involved. As a matter of fact, we can even speak up at meetings and you know, give our views on different things. So this is just great, being able to go out together. I'm all for that.
So you don't feel like left out then when you go to a meeting?
No, it's they're very, very good to the wives. They see that we're drawn in just as much as the men. Like, as I say, at any meetings or in anything that's said and done, we are able to voice our opinions too, and I think that's really great.
Thank you. And Deb, how do you feel about this chapter in this area?
I feel
this.
I just came to praise the Lord. I just came to praise the Lord. I just came to praise his name. I just came to praise the Lord. I just came to thank the Lord. I just came to thank the Lord. I just came to praise his name. I just came to thank the Lord. He came into my life one very special day. He came into my heart to show me a better way. He said he would never depart, and this is why I sing. I just came to praise the Lord.
Glory, happy reunions on
on streets of gold. Angel choir singing glad praises forever, but Jesus will outshine them all. Glory, happy reunions on streets of gold, angel choir singing glad praises forever, but Jesus will outshine them all. Glory, happy reunions on streets of gold, angel choir singing glad praises forever, but Jesus will outshine it all. Yes, my Jesus will outshine them.